The ninth round has started. Asterion versus Progression. And Rix, why don't you give us a roster rundown?
I will do so. For Asterion, we got Amos, Kindetli, Lumi, Kinzo, and Relax. As for Progression, we got Dom Convic, Ferment, Spinem, and Primor. And so far, the ninth seems to be going in the favor of Asterion, as it will. They will probably start on that CT site. Amos just confirmed that. So, yeah, Asterion. My prediction wise, I think Asterion should wipe the table clean with Progression on this map, but we'll see. We know we all like to root for the underdogs, but I think it's
we'll
going to be an uphill struggle.
Asterion versus Progression on Mirage, first map of the evening in week 7 of the ESL Benelux Championships. That is the last online week in about 2 weeks. Yeah, in 2 weeks, next weekend, we'll be in the Amsterdam Arena with the finals. And now we're going to see Progression try and stick it to Asterion here on the pistol round on their T side.
Yeah, indeed. And heading towards B, it's Lunium to find himself that first frag, spin him down. And Lunium finds himself the second shot as the third one as well. And Kinzo comes in, shuts down for men. It's going to be down to Primer, who actually manages to pick himself up 2 kills. And Lunium can't quite connect that shot. Primer now stuck in the position where he's just behind that truck. He fires off the pistol, but Lunium comes peeking again. And Lunium now finds himself in a bit of an awkward fight. He's run out of bullets, and Primer takes him out. But finally, Kindetli will put an end to Primer's killing spree, 1-0.
That looked so nice at the start. There were so many one taps. It looked like it was going backwards and forwards, and then it sort of got clumsy behind the bench there. But, you know, let's hope nobody saw that. And Asterion pick up the first round. They go with two SMGs, two rifles, and a scout. A nice little mix of stuff, mix of rifles they pick up here. And Progression back against the wall from the start as they lose that pistol round, but they think they have the answer here with this full execute onto the A site, and well, it should at least reward them with a bomb plant.
Yeah, let's hope they do get that bomb down, but it's again Relax and Kindetli. Kindetli firing off those shots with the SMG, picks up 3 kills, make that 4 as well, as Relax did downspin him 2-0 again. Relax and Kindetli just performing so great on that A bomb site. 2-0 for Asterion, as Kindetli's bank account has just increased by a triple amount.
And that was definitely not worth the investment out of Progression. They invested quite heavily into that round. They all had some grenades to make that execute happen. They had some pistols and Kevlar. And what they get out of it? One frag. Kinzo starting off well with the first, and Relax immediately after with a second. 2-man advantage here. Not much to work with on the Progression side, but still, you would like to get some frags on that T side.
Yeah, well, there's one frag from Spinem, but is it going to be it? Oh, Kindetli actually coming in a backside, but he decided to go towards middle. There's 2 players left for the Ts, just those P250s to hand, and looks like Kindetli is hungry for those frags. Spinem, though, not being tagged up yet. We'll get tagged up now. Kindetli, bit of a skirmish there as he pulls out the 5-7, will take him out. Convic did pick up a kill on Sumos, but that is going to be it. 3-0, still a relatively nice cleanup from Asterion. And now Kinzo with the 8LP. Is Kinzo always an op? I thought it was more of a Lumi thing.
We see Kinzo picking it up every once in a while. Kindetli definitely always has it, but yeah, Kinzo or Lumi, like you say, tend to pick up the second one. But I think Lumi likes it better on the T side, but I'm not entirely sure. Either way, first gun round out of both teams here. Progression finally managed to squeeze together a buy here, as it's not even that bad of a buy with 5 AKs. Plenty of utility, it seems. They still have enough smokes and flashes to make their way into a bomb site, but they can't really go for very elaborate fakes. So they do have middle control here, and that's something that they can work with, as they do have a lurker on either side of the map, so they can split wherever they get the first frag.
Yeah, I guess it's nice for the T's that they have got Convic in that connector area, waiting to see if he can get any peeks, though. Kinzo out in middle, on the A bomb side, in fact, and picks up a beautiful kill into Ferment. And that was a really nice reaction time shot. Now, Kindetli, he does spot one out in window. So he can't really go there. He's actually going to go towards Kinzo. Now you have 2 ops on that CT spawn. If Progression managed to smoke them out, then they might be able to look out Asterion from that bomb site, as Relax now goes down. And Kinzo going on top of that Nuisance, does pick off Primer and spin him with that bomb fake. He still hasn't planted it yet, but will do so now. It's a 2 versus 3 as that bomb goes down. And most, they pick up a frag and Deadly will follow on to spin him. It is Convict to go down. To actually pick up the kill on the Moe's, and the bomb has been defused. Convict not peeking.
Okay then, well, that was interesting, especially that push out of Kind Deadly, just stepping around the corner with his AWP, not giving a damn. And he picked up that frag, so that was well done by them. Double AWPs just holding that crossfire, actually one of them was defusing, and the other one was holding it, and no interruption at that from the T's, but they do have enough money to get another buy because of the frags and the bomb plant that they did get, and we have Config on the AWP now, so those two AWPs on the CT side could get contested here by Config.
Yeah, that is always the thing. But Config, you know, with just that glass cannon, he already had some damage from a grenade incoming. It's nothing too much to worry about, though. And again, a bit of a slow-paced round from Progression. Looks like that bomb is slowly creeping its way towards B, where you have Lumi and both Amos waiting for their presence. And, well, slow-paced round, Progression.
Well, what would be nice for Progression in this situation is if they can work off the back of a pick coming out of that AWP that they have. But Config was still making his way towards that B site as he was speaking elsewhere before. And so they've been standing still for quite a while now. And now that they do spot him, they start to use their utility with less than a minute left on the clock. That means that it's going to be running down quite tightly for Progression here before all these smokes and Molotovs dissipate. But it looks like Asterion isn't willing to over-rotate. As I say that, actually, Kinzo makes his way from the Sniper's Nest area to the kitchen. Three men on and around this B site now, and the push is going to come in from Progression.
Ooh, Kinzo there missing the shot. Now it's Amos with the SMG combined with Lumi to take out two. Lumi, in fact, picking up the glory as he takes out two. There's Kinzo finally with the 8 LP taking out Spinem. Lumi chimes back with another frag. Three kills for him. It's Convict down to 4 HP. You will get taken out by Kindetli as well. 5-0, and that's exactly why you should not push at this time when there is so much utility still left from Asterion. And they knew exactly what was going on.
It was too slow play. It was as if they were basing the entire round on a pick that they got from the AWP, which never really happened, and no one else had been playing for picks because they didn't want to die. They wanted to have the man advantage, and that never happened. So in the end, it was actually the man who was supposed to get the entry frag who was still alive, and that didn't go all that well. So back on pistols now, and they're going to try their A execute again. See if it works this time.
Well, it's still Kindetli and Relax on that side, and so far, they've been proving a very strong combo, but just the Deck 9s, Relax with the M4, Kindetli, he still actually has some vision, in fact, and now they are gonna come in, and Kinzo rotating already, Relax, there we go. Oh, it's only one kill, though. Kinzo and Kindetli will come up, too, collectively, and now Kinzo on that bomb side tagging up a player, but Kindetli and Kinzo both going down. This might be actually a bit of a sloppy player from Asterion, as now Lumi goes down. It's down to Amos, 1 versus 2, and will go down to Don as well. So there we go. There's the first round on the board for Progression.
Wow, and that worked out very well. I was sort of mockingly saying, see if it works this time, because last time that push, that exact same execute, just got obliterated. And not this time. They managed to pick up some key frags. Got rifles out of that, and then we had the man with the AWP step up massively, and was that Primor?
Don
had 4k, yeah, of course, but Don grabbed that AWP and picked up at least two very important frags with that after already managing to obtain it, so well done by him, but hopefully it isn't going to take a 4k out of a player for every round that Progression has to win on this side, because I'm not sure if they have the consistency for that.
Yeah, like you said, I mean, I don't know, I feel that Progression, they were just a little bit too cocky. Kinzo just going immediately on top of that bomb side, kind of exposing him to the elements of the Tech 9, while he could have just sit back and wait for Amos and Lumi to come by. I don't know, like, sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't, and in that round it clearly didn't.
Yeah, well, the way the previous rounds have been going, you can't blame Asterion that much for being a little bit overconfident. I said it the round before, I think, as well, when Kindetli just walked into the site with his AWP and shot the remaining terrorist, I can't remember who that was, just in the face, and no one sees that coming because an AWP doesn't generally just step out of CT and shoot at you mm-hmm. in a 2v1 or a 2v2, whatever. So that proves that they are more confident, but that also makes them less predictable. So it, in that sense, it can work either positively or negatively for them. But the fact that there are only four players in the server definitely does work negatively. I'm thinking one of them might have needed a restart. I thought this was a tactical timeout.
I don't know. Let's see in the chat.
I think it's
tech issue.
Yeah. Actually, timeout.
It was gold. Okay.
Well, no problem. Anyway, it's important for progression to not sink in now and not convert onto this. Like, they have to capitalize on the fact that they managed to pick up this round. They didn't really manage to do the job in the economy of Asterion. They'll be able to buy, but if progression lose this round, then they will not be able to buy themselves next round and just screw themselves over economically. So,
yeah. So, I wonder what's gonna happen. I mean, I think my money is definitely still in Asterion. So, either way.
Yes. Yeah. I also think Asterion have a far better chance at getting through this, and they are currently the third ranked team in the standings. So, if you want to check that out, type !! standings in the chat. By the way, but yeah, they are likely to win. But progression, I don't want to count them out quite yet. And they did manage to pick up their first round. Asterion only have 5 on their CT side. This can go in either direction still. And if I think we've seen upsets coming out of progression before throughout the league, so definitely wouldn't count them out. But if Kindedly and Kinzo just keep playing the way they have been, then it would be a tough challenge.
Yeah, looks like Relax is back in the server right now, so we should be going on the way anytime soon. Match has been paused. There we go. We are live once again with Asterion progression. It is 5-1 to Asterion progression. They pick up the last round, so we're on the 7th round right now, and wondering if Convic will make that up work.
Right. Well, Kindedly and Kinzo still both have one despite losing that last round. So in terms of money, they were still fine, but this is depleting it a little bit for them. And middle control seems to be something that the terrorists want to opt for, not something we see all the time in these championships. But it looks like they're successful. Lumi not peeking too far into that, and Kinzo just holding an angle from short, but he decides to fall back as well, and terrorist advancing on short, trying to get to the B site.
Wow, Kinzo not connecting that shot. Lumi though does retaliate with 2 kills, and now it's a 2v3. It's getting a little bit trickier for Asterion, because if they lose this round, then they're not going to have too much money on their bank accounts. Looks like that bomb is going to get planted. Kindedly, with his eyes peeled on Convict's position. Convict just needs to move for Kindedly to pick him off, but it's not gonna happen just yet, as Kindedly will make his way forward, but will get shut down by Spinem. It is Relax now, 1v3. Does pick up the frag, the primer, but Convict comes around, takes him out, 5-2. And, well, I don't know, Kinzo peeking from short and staying in such a close angle, it's risky, and it definitely didn't pay off in that regard. And now progression, they should be able to pick up another round and make it 5-3, really.
Well, it's well done by progression to string these two together to start with, especially with that double op setup that Asterion had going on. And this is sort of the kickstart that they need in order to have a good half here. They are the ones with the rifles now. And please don't screw it up by rushing too elaborately into this stack.
Oh man, Lumi Amos with 2 kills with the PT-50, picks up another one. And there is Amos. Going absolutely big just when it's needed. 2v1. It's Convic. We'll go down to Relax, and can you believe it? Asterion.
Very disappointing play coming out of progression. They should have, well, knowing that they won 2 rounds in a row, they should be able to anticipate that the economy of Asterion is low and that there's likely only pistols, which are very effective in close quarters, like the B apartments. And the fact that they just decide to charge in there with 5 people, all on rifles, even an op, not a very educated decision. But so But as a result of that, they're now back on two pistols. They still have some rifles working for them. But Asterion back in a full buy, back on what they're comfortable with. Double op, three rifles, and back in the driver's seat.
Wow. Kinzo, such a close angle on Palace. Just taking out one player that's done down and out. And now four more players remain. And it looks like they were going to go for that A push. And I don't know, they seem to be slowing down and going back towards T-spawn, where Moe's is actually waiting for them.
It did pull out a lot of rotation coming out of CTs, but Moe's has so much map control here. They're going to have to root him out, and Config manages to do exactly that. And with the rotation still all the way over towards the A side, if they go quick, they can get this bomb down, but they want to double fake it. The bomb slowly going back towards A, and they're making this way more confusing than it has to be. But it is working out, it seems. Two CTs are over towards the B site, one in the middle, and the A site is most deserted with only one player there. So if they manage to team up Primor and Spinem, that is, they could take the A site, but with only 35 seconds left on their clock, they seem quite hesitant. Spinem looked like he wanted to take middle control and is now actually going back towards the B apartments.
I think this is just a case where you overthink things a little bit too much.
A little bit, yeah.
And, well, there goes Primor. That bomb is actually still heading towards B, but Lumi is going to hear them all. And that should be a call. There's Kindatli already in position, already to take out Convict. But Spinem actually does manage to get himself that bomb down. 1v4, makes it down to a 1v3 as Kindatli does not connect the shot. Spinem with another frag, taking out Kinzo. Can this be possible? Two more to find. Kindatli and both Relax are coming from Shord. Spinem shows himself as Relax being tagged up. Now, Spinem, can he do it? Spots Kindatli and downs him. One on one, Relax coming up close. And Spinem does spot him in the nick of time. Spinem, can you do it, my man? As he will look around, but Relax takes him out.
But, he doesn't have time to defuse. Fair enough. So that worked out for Spinem. That was a very, very nice clutch. Was that? That might have been 1v4. Was he the last one alive? Yeah. That was a 1v4 clutch. Well done, Spinem. And, that gets them another round on the board. Unfortunately, this is actually the second time it took someone to just go absolutely mental for them to win a round. But, you know, as long as the rounds get on the board, I suppose that's not much of a problem. And economy for Asterion not looking that good. Kinzo managed to escape with that AWP in the previous round, so that might be something to play off the back off of. But I would say that, especially with that Mac 10 off a Ment, Progression can have a very good time in this round. They can just use him as a decoy, charge in, get some information, maybe find some easy frags, because not all of them have armor. And based on that, they can do something rather than just rushing into B apartments with full rifles.
Yeah, Kinzo, he does have that up, and he's looking towards middle, where tremendous beautiful shot by Kinzo to take him out. And now Config just right below him. He's just going to adjust his position right here, and Relax might actually just meet up with three players who are heading towards A, and he's left quite alone on that bomb side. I think Convict is actually doing a great job at keeping those CTs at the other bomb side. Now Relax, eyes on you as Kinzo makes his rotation towards the CT spawn as well. The bomb is not going to get planted. Relax manages to deny that bomb plant, sorry. And now boosted up is Kinzo to take out Primor, and Convict does pick himself up two kills. Will that be the savior? Kindatli will go down to Spinem as well. 2v2, but look at the HP from Progression. It is down to nothing. Kinzo going for the wall back. What a shot. 1-on-1, Relax versus Spinem. This is a very viable situation for Relax to take out Spinem. If only he can have one shot. That is good enough. But Spinem will now walk away. Can he be the hero once again?
He has been playing very well for his team, but Relax really wants to pick up this kill, and the HP on Spinem is not on his side, and Relax actually has a kit. He has plenty of time to do this. Spinem thinks he's faking, and pros don't fake, mate, and he gets taken down as well. So Relax, balls of steel, holds that down, picks up another round for Asterion, and now it's starting to get very, very tight for Progression, because money on their side, not really flourishing. So they can get a couple of pistols, maybe some Kevlar here and there, but this is not looking all that likely, and Asterion back on the double op. Where do they keep getting these things from?
I don't know. It's it's so magic to me. I mean, Relax didn't even manage to save one off, so it just seemed to be keep buying it, and now Relax already opening up with two kills. Lumi with one, Kid Deadly follows up. It's Ferment, your last man standing. Looks like he's just gonna play it carefully and hope to find himself one more frag. Amos is watching sort of his position. Kinzo will spot him. Looks like Amos wants to close out this round as he creeps his way forward. Ooh, Amos! Dear me, not gonna happen like that.
Kind of Deadly in a good position to deal with that though, but that was a little bit sloppy. But it might have been the, you know, the framework, the metal stuff on short in the corner that actually soaks a lot of bullets. But I don't know. Not my case to defend. Anyway, double op on Asterion again. Doesn't matter how many they lose, they just keep getting them. And progression on another buy. 8-3 is the score in favor of Asterion. And progression is going to need at least two more rounds, in my opinion, if they want to have a chance in the rest of this map. And it's not starting off all that well for them, with Kind Deadly picking up yet another entry frag.
Yeah, Kind Deadly actually just shooting him down through the smoke. And there's Kinzo with another smoke shot as well. Kind Deadly follows up with the frag of the convict. That is just sick play. And two ops picking up three kills collectively. That is great in the first couple of seconds of the round. And well, Spinem revealing his position by jumping up and down on the B apps. Looks like Primor has just been shut down by Kinzo as well. So two kills for Kinzo, two kills for Kindetli. Ops doing great. And Spinem, 1v5. Can he pull out some magic as that bomb is still out there in middle though? What is he going to do? He's in such a tough situation. As Lillian will finally take him out. 9-3 it is then. Asterion now walking away with a 6-round lead as progression. They are probably going to be down to just buying P250s, looking at that current money situation.
This is their last opportunity. Like, they can save this round now. That's the last round they'll be able to save. And then the next two, they'll just have to pick up if they want to have a chance throughout the rest of this bloody map, because Asterion is gaining way too much of a lead. Like you said, 6 rounds they have on progression right now, and let's see if this compact play out of progression is going to make a difference. Molotovs, grenades coming out of Asterion, they seemed prepared for that. Config all the way down to 8 HP, he took all of that face first, but they're not slowing down. They're just going to continue pushing into that B side, it seems.
Yeah, Mo's actually putting a lot of wallbangs on Convict as well, which is really cool to see. But now, Mo's does tag up another player. He seems to be tagging up loads and finally does take out Spinem. Lumi comes in with 2 kills, relax down to a man. Daenerys and Mo's for the second frag of the round. 10-3, and well, Asterion, like we sort of predicted, they should be walking away with this kind of easily, but we'll see. Two more rounds to be played for progression on their T side. And that's those 2 rounds that they're definitely going to need heading towards the second half.
Well, those 2 rounds start with this one, because if they can't manage to pick up this one, they won't have money once again. And I don't fancy their chances, with just pistols on the last round of the half. So this round is where it has to start. This round is where they need to get a comeback of some sort. And let's kick it off with an entry frag for someone. Come on, Convict, you have an op again, but you're just so passive in this palace. Try and find a frag somewhere like Ferment does as he picks up Kind Deadly there.
Yeah, it did cost him something, but again, a frag is nice and they might be able to mix up the defense of Asterion and make them feel a little bit more uncomfortable. However, Asterion, they are definitely well in the driver's seat. And let's pick it up with Convict here as he does know somewhere where Kinzo is and connects the shot as well. So that is going to be 2 frags in for progression. That bomb still around B, and this is actually a really nice fake, because Asterion are all rotating towards the other bomb side, and now we have bomb moving in. Primor did get taken out by Relax, but Lumi chimes in with 2 kills, with 3 as well! And Lumi single-handedly defended the B bomb side. And it's going to be 11-3.
Yeah, I suppose that's sort of where you have to draw the line for progression and say, like, maybe, guys, this isn't really your type of opponent quite yet, but keep on practicing, because that's just Lumi stepping up and showing who's boss around that B site. So they did manage to pick up some rifles on the T site. Quick push into the A side, actually. Ferment manages to pick up a frag, but they lose two members in the process of taking that site. No smokes or anything to block off connector with, it seems, and that's costing them dearly. Ferment managed to get one more frag, but Kinzo found the return, and two versus two now.
Wow. Ken Deadly, as soon as he showed himself, he got immediately annihilated by Convict. But Convict will get taken out now by Amos. One versus two for Spinner. Can he pick up that frag? No, he can't. Kinzo will take him out, and this will be 12-3 for Asterion. Pretty much of a nightmare scenario, I'd say, for progression. It's going to be so tough for them to come back from this one. The first thing that they will need is the pistol round to start claiming rounds back. But Asterion, they are a strong team. Very tough to crack.
Yeah. They managed to get that bomb site. It was actually looking quite promising in this last round here, but Spinem sort of couldn't connect his spray. He was even commenting on it in chat afterwards. He realizes that that wasn't very slick, but like you say, their chances in their CT half wouldn't be all that big, but they do exist nonetheless. And if they do manage to pick up that pistol round, then you never know where it can lead on the CT side of Mirage. But for now, Asterion is definitely in the driver's seat still, and all they need is the pistol round, and they basically bring this home, and that would put them in the second spot of the standings, wouldn't it?
That would indeed be, yeah. Third place, they're in third place right now on 13 points, so that means the maximum amount of points that you would get is 16. That would be equal with Lola Alliance.
Yeah, okay, but Venko and Lola Alliance still need to play, so that could be taken into account, but sure. Lola Alliance is first, right?
At the moment, they are first. But
yeah, okay,
Venko,
so they can still play second.
Mm-hmm. If Venko beat Lola Alliance, then yeah.
Okay, cool. Well, we're in the pistol round, it seems, and it's quite an aggressive one.
Yeah, let's take it over at the progression side, as Convict will go down already. Primer, he's getting annihilated by all these T's as Lumi shuts him down. Lumi, in fact, with two opening kills. And Ferment goes down quickly afterwards. Don, the only man to reply so far, taking out Kinzo. Spinem will go down. It's going to be down to Don with just 2 HP left. It's going to be that mission impossible as he makes his way towards connector, but not for very long as Amos takes him out. 13-3. And well, that didn't go very well.
Asterion not kidding around. They're here. They had fun in this league, but they just want to collect their standings, you know, get the last 3 points out of this matchup so that they can get the better placing in the LAN finals or in 2 weeks. And, well, progression is sort of the only thing that's standing in their way right now, and they don't seem to mind. They're going right through them.
Yeah, they're plowing through them. Kin Deadly with the SMG spearheading the attack. Oh my god, Relax taking out Convict, and, well, Relax finds himself another kill as he looks to pick up another pistol kill. Kinzo, though, does down Primer, and finally Relax will go down. Spinem and Ferment, your last two alive, as Kinzo will go ahead and plant that bomb. Both players from the CTs are coming from short, as Spinem does manage to pick himself a kill. Ferment as well, 2 versus 2, with Kinzo being very low, though, but an AK in the hands of Lumi, and a well-capable hands of him as well. And Kinzo will actually go down now, and now it's going to be 1 versus 1, but Lumi, again, proving to be too strong with an assault rifle, making it 14-3.
Okay then, 14 rounds for Asterion, just counting down. All they need is 2 more, and progression really have no money to defend themselves with, and yet they decide to invest it. So we've got some Kevlar with helmets here and there. Everyone has an upgraded pistol and at least one grenade. But that's not exactly an optimal buy versus these 4 rifles on the Asterion side and Kind Deadly, just for the show of it, with this UMP.
Yeah, looks like Don has been spotted. Don, though, picking up 2 kills. Make that 3! Oh, wow, that is just absolutely sensational play from Don, but it's a 1 versus 1 as Spinem does close it out.
That was an interesting round. Like, Don steps up, gets 3 1-deegs. And then all of a sudden, everyone on the CT side is dying anyway. But, you know, in the whiff of an eye, they managed to clutch that out and pick up a round for themselves. So that awkward force buy did result into a round win. Their 4th one in total versus the 14 that Asterion are on right now. But it's never impossible. And with the guns that Asterion have right now, it might not be that unrealistic to pick up at least one or two more before the next challenge. Asterion just slowly top of mid, taking control there, and look like they just want to rush out short. And, well, the CTs aren't really holding it either, not from the A site or from B, so they're just able to run out short here and take this B site.
Wow, they were, like, blissfully unaware, and now Spitem and Femen getting taken out. Looks like Asterion, they actually managed to get himself full control over that B bomb site. Kin Deadly did take out one, but there he is, dropped to 3 HP. Primor will pick up that kill onto Kin Deadly. Yamos will go down as well. 3v3 off the plant, and it seems to be favoring the CTs as Convict picks himself up 2 kills with the SMG. It's Relax, with no armor to his name, did pick up an SMG, will down Dawn as the defuse does come in. Relax looking to stop that, but it's not gonna happen. Does pick up that kill on the primer in the end, but will be the round for Progression.
That was so ridiculously risky by Progression by not holding middle at all. They had 3 players on A and 2 on B, and neither of them were peeking into middle through either short or connector. Asterion managed to get that site almost for free. And then luckily we had Config mainly going mad with his MP9, and everyone just came in and picked up some frags, and they managed to recover that round. But that was too close for comfort, if you ask me. And Asterion, off the back of that bomb plant and the frags that they got, have enough money in this round to just get a proper buyout. They have plenty of utility, 5 rifles, and they even have a better buy than Progression, I would say. So it looks like they just want to be taking this A site now. No shit around middle, just quick and clean in there.
Yeah, looks like Primer was taken down early on. Done though, again, picking up 2 kills, which is really nice for the CTs. But now they're gonna have to rotate, and those wall of smokes are still up. Convict though does manage to take out 2 kills, actually spraying through the box as well. And Kinzo, your last man standing, will get taken out as well. So Progression, they're hanging on in there.
Yeah, Don and Config just taking turns in stepping up for their team, and spin them some very nice clutches together. They're almost a decent team. They're almost just hanging, or they're almost making it exciting against Asterion here, but they do still have the 14-6 advantage on their side. And despite the fact that I don't have any money now, they can do 5 ecos if they want to, and all by negatives, and they'll still have a realistic chance of winning.
That sounded so much like BM, all by negatives.
Yeah, well, it is, but just for scale of measurement, like, they would still have a realistic chance of winning.
Watch it now, Femen. This is your moment. Come
exactly.
on. This is your moment to shine.
Well, look at Spinem, already very aggressively up top mid. He could come up behind them if they don't push quickly. This is going to be a rock and a hard place for Asterion if they just stand still here.
Yeah.
They push at the exact right time.
Well, Femen didn't do too much there. He did pick up a kill. Convict did pick up a kill as well. There's Spinem finally coming in the back to take out one. But again, a bomb plant for Asterion, which is not too shabby at all considering what they had.
Yeah, they didn't invest all that much. They got a bomb plant and a frag out of it. And it could have worked out very nicely for Progression if either Ferment would have been a little bit more aggressive, would have helped them back a little bit more, or if Config would have been quicker on that flank. But in the end, it doesn't matter all that much for Asterion, Progression, I mean. The economy of their opponents, well, it affects them because it matters how much they can buy, of course, but they're going to have more buy rounds anyway. And for Progression, it's just round to round, get the numbers on the board, and claw your way back up there. And so far, they've been doing exactly that. Picked up 4 rounds in a row, 14-7 now, and they're still only on half the amount of rounds that Asterion have. At least it's becoming more and more likely that they're able to do it.
Yeah, looks like Asterion again opting to go for that A push, as they just need to take out Don, who's he's always been on that side, always just right below. And again, Don delivers with a frag. Primer will pick up one, but the melee will go down. It's a 2-for-2 trade. And that bomb plant now going down to the courtesy of Lumi. Flashbang did come in, but not gonna deter him just yet. Kinzo being picked up by Spinem. Lumi will return as he downs Convict. Spinem coming in the backside, taking out Lumi as well. 1v2 for Kinzo. Kin Deadly, in fact, as he's actually being Molotov'd off. And
no, he doesn't have the HP. He doesn't have the HP to walk through the Molotov.
He's just gonna save it as well. There's nothing he could do.
Okay, so well played by Progression, good retake by them, and Asterion, they do manage to get another bomb plant, but No round win for them. Luckily, Kindedly managed to hang on to that op, because that means that in terms of buying in this round, that's no problem at all. But Progression also on a full buy. They have an op working for them on Config. And, well, it looks like they're taking quite aggressive control of these of this back alley, but they slowed down quite quickly as well. And I'm not sure what they're headed, but middle control is definitely going in the favor of CT so far, as Primor picks up the first frag.
Yeah, so far so good, and looks like Primer was gonna go peeking out, but not against Kindedly. It's not gonna work out well for you, and now Amos watching the window. Convic gonna be there, but he's being tagged up by a grenade, so not very likely he's gonna show himself. And so far, Asterion, they got themselves great middle control, and it's not really being contested too much by Progression. They are, you know, happy to sit back. Oh, Convict, that's really a frag that you should have had. Yeah, can't connect the second shot as well. Kinzo jumping up and down. And looks like that bomb is going to make its way towards B, where Spinem is going to be hiding in that corner. But he's been molotoved, and he's been forced back off. And looks like this bomb is actually going to make its way towards A, maybe, as a Moses is carrying it down.
And with only Dawn on this site, that could be very, very interesting. Look at how spread out they are, but all the map control that they have, Dawn manages to pick up Kindedly, but there's still one more terrorist around there and no CTs for backup.
Yeah, but Asterion, they need to capitalize on this momentum before it's too late.
They're not really moving. Waiting to get grouped up, finally. Relax has teamed up with his mate Amos, and the bomb does seem like it's going down. And we do still have Kinzo in a fairly good position, but Amos probably not going to be able to get out of there alive. Kinzo managed to pick up a frag onto Ferment, and this 2v3 might not be all that undoable, but we do have Spinem coming up from behind, and that could be disastrous here, as Kinzo does go down. 1v3 now for Amos, as he's dancing behind these boxes, doesn't connect that shot onto Config, gets taken down, and three members left alive for Progression. They're slowly clawing their way back into this. Another bomb plant for Asterion nonetheless, but this is going well for them.
Yeah, six rounds in a row for Progression. That is starting to get really impressive by them. And especially, I mean, from those six rounds, there were four defuses as well.
Yeah, so they're definitely doing
well
in
the retakes. Yeah, exactly.
Maybe that has something to do with the fact that A is the site that's being retaken all the time. So, you know, all the Spinem and Config are playing on middle and B, so they always retake. Anyway, Lumi gets an entry frag onto Spinem, exactly the man I was just talking about, and this could get frisky very quickly with Ferment locked in this site here, and well, the only support that he has is in the kitchen, but as the rotation from the CTs comes in, it seems like the T's also would rather go towards a different part of the map, as the bomb has made its way into middle, and Kinzo starts pushing into the A site.
There is Dawn coming in the back from the T spawn, but will get spotted by Kindedly and downed. Primor does pick up a kill onto Amo, so a bit of a trade frag there, but still going into the favor of Asterion, as they did pick up the initial frag as well. Now it looks like Asterion, they're going to make their way towards the A bomb site where Primor is going to be at. So let's pick it up with Primor himself, as he's going to be just about that CT side and it's going to be smoked off. Lumi plants the bomb and it's going to be the time ticking away in the favor of Asterion. This time they have so much better after plant situations and positions as well. It's a 3v3. The CTs are kind of bleeding internally, looking at Ferment on 15 HP, Convict down to 57. As they will slowly approach, they really don't have any idea where they are. Lumi now picking up a kill as he drops him, and Kindedly will down Primer. Will this be the match point for Asterion, as Convict will back off with just 5 HP remaining as well?
Okay, so finally Asterion managed to pick up another round, but it took them seven tries before they managed to do it. Either way, that is a match point in their pocket, and that's what happens if your T side is so weak, on Progression's side anyway, because they just didn't have the rounds, they didn't have the margin that they should have created for themselves in order to lose a few on the CT side. Losing that pistol round also put them in an even worse position, and now that they did string a nice amount of rounds together, they finally lose one, and suddenly there's a match point up against them, and their economy isn't all that great either. Ferment does manage to find the first frag, though. That could go a long way, because that gets him a rifle, and that was the only player who was only on a pistol. So man advantage, dig in, don't get too aggressive, and progression might be able to upset the economy of Asterion and claw their way back up.
Yeah, that might be a little bit sad too soon.
Too enthusiastic?
Yeah, I think it is, because Kinzo now taken out Ferment with no problem at all. I know. But it's not always to be.
It isn't.
I mean, looking at the weaponry, it's far superior for Asterion. They still have utility as well, and there's virtually none on progression. In fact, there is none. Well, looks like Asterion looking to close this one out as they make their way towards B. Eyes are going to be on Don, as he is that man defending it. Will spot himself the first one, and that's Kinzo down and out. Now, Lumi going to come in, and Don will find himself the second as well. Such a crucial frags here by Don, and spin him still around that corner, and he's not been checked at all. Kin Deadly will go down. It's going to be down to a Moe's 1v3. If you want to close this one out right now, 20 seconds remain. That bomb is out there on the B-bomb side. Looks like he was going to go for it, but Convict is going to be there.
Yeah, so despite the inferior weaponry, progression, they're not held back. They managed to make that work off the back of two UMP kills Don got there, and that makes it all possible. This is their opportunity to get back into a, well, they can't win this anymore, but they can still get to a tie, and that would upset the scoreboard in a very amusing way, I imagine, because that would mean that other teams have the opportunity to get that second place, because Asterion doesn't gain that many points. And yeah, that would be interesting to see. I don't think progression can actually still make it to the finals, though. But, you know, keep you updated on that throughout the breaks, because I will be looking that up. But it looks like we got another 8-8 coming in here from Asterion, but not a very successful one, as Primorch and Dawn pick up frags. Relax and Kinzo, though, managed to return some, but Ferment comes up from CT and picks up Relax. That's only Kinzo left alive now. Wasn't all that heavy of an investment coming out of Asterion, but a bomb plant would go a very, very long way. Not meant to be, though.
Wow. I'm just so surprised progression even got to this point, you know?
The underdog prevails, I'm telling you. It's finally going to happen. I've been predicting it for 7 weeks now, and finally, it's going to happen. It's going to come true. Actually, I'm not that sure.
Thing is, though, progression, there's no way they can get to the Amsterdam Arena.
Yeah, I know. But they can upset the scoreboard. Like, they can at least keep it interesting.
It's for the honor.
Exactly. You know, just not going to go out with their heads down. They want to have their heads high as they're not walking out the arena.
Ooh, damn me, spin him. One of the B-Habs getting taken out there by Lumi and Asterion. Yeah. They get themselves the great setup now for an afterplan situation for that B-bomb side, as two players from the progression making their way towards a short. You have got Primor coming in from the B-Habs, and this is going to be very much of an uphill struggle, especially with so many angles to watch.
Oh, and
there's all the utility coming in indeed, and well, Amo speaking about, but there's not too much damage being done at all. Look at that boost though, but Dom managing to take out two kills there, Amo, and Relax will chime back, and Dom can't do it all. We'll get taken out by Relax, 16-11. Asterion finally win this one, and that is
so progression trying to keep their heads maybe a little bit too high as they go a bit too aggressively into those B apartments, and they get punished for that. Asterion got way too easy entrance into the B site, and they managed to lock it down after that, despite the good utility usage on progression. Didn't happen for them, and to be honest, nothing all that surprising. The underdog is still the underdog, and they can't always prevail, unfortunately. So, exciting game nonetheless. They managed to claw their way back up on their CT side quite a bit. They didn't manage to clutch it out. Asterion prevail, and for now, this should put Asterion in the second place for the LAN finals. Mm-hmm.